चिंतनगणेशं मूलमयं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपं अधिष्ठानं बुद्धेबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्षेत्रं पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवान्नमत्वं निश्चितामतिः। वीसा अवच्छेदवाद वीसादि प्रतिबिंबवाद एंड आभासवाद एंड डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन देम। नाउ अवच्छेदवाद, अवच्छेदवाद इज कंपैरेटिवली सिंपलर। कतिपय ग्रंथेषु शुद्ध सत्व गुणोपेत माया विशिष्ट चैतन्यम ईश्वरः, मलिन सत्व गुणोपेत अंतकरण उपादान कारणीभूत अविद्यांश विशिष्ट चैतन्यम जीव इति च कथ्यते। हु इज ईश्वर? इन मेनी ग्रंथास ईश्वर इज मेंशनड एज हैविंग एन उपाधि ऑफ माया विच इज हैविंग सत्वगुण और विच इज मेड अप ऑफ सत्वगुण प्राइमरली। सो शुद्ध सत्वगुण एंडोर्ड विथ शुद्ध सत्वगुण यू हैव माया एंड दैट माया विशिष्ट बिकम्स अ विशेषण टू चैतन्य देयर बाय दैट उपाधि सीन एज विशेषण मेक्स ब्रह्म ईश्वर। दिस इज द जनरल अंडरस्टैंडिंग विच वी यूज एज वेल इन मेनी प्लेसेस। मलिन सत्व गुणोपेत अंतकरण उपादान कारणीभूत अविद्यांश विशिष्ट चैतन्य इज जीव। सो मलिन सत्व मीनिंग दैट सत्व गुण विच इज मिक्स्ड अप विथ और टेंटेड बाय रजस एंड तमस गुणस दैट काइंड ऑफ गुण इज देयर इन अंतकरण एंड उपादान कारण मैनिफेस्ट इटसेल्फ इन द कार्य। देयरफॉर उपादान कारण इज दैट विच रियली हैज मलिन सत्व गुण एंड दैट इज अविद्या। अविद्या इज एन अंश ऑफ माया और माया इटसेल्फ इज कॉल्ड एज अविद्या। बट वी हैव सीन अविद्या एंड अविद्या अंश ऑल्सो। इफ यू टेक सिंगल अविद्या ऑल्सो देर इज एन अविद्या अंश बट जनरली Maya is in the samashti and at vyasti level we call it as avidya. Same Maya is called as avidya. So there are many avidya aushas, there is one Maya. And this avidya, when it becomes visheshana to the chaitanya, that entity is called as jiva. Ayam eva avachhedavada इति उच्यते। वेदांतेषु प्रक्रिया भेदा सर्वे अपि अद्वैत आत्मावगमार्थाः एव। वॉट एवर बी दि प्रक्रिया इन वेदांत वेदर इट इज आभासवाद प्रतिबिंबवाद अवच्छेदवाद और यू यूज दृष्टि सृष्टिवाद सृष्टि दृष्टिवाद इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट इज दिस क्रिएशन ऑल अबाउट इट इज ऑल यूज्ड टू अंडरस्टैंड दि आत्मतत्व एज लॉन्ग एज यू लैंड ऑन ऐक्य एनी प्रक्रिया इज ओके। सो भगवान सुरेश्वराचार्य सेज इन बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद वार्तिका ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज वार्तिककार ही सेज दैट एनी प्रक्रिया विच लीड्स टू द अवबोध ऑफ प्रत्यगात्म दैट प्रक्रिया इज अ साध्वी प्रक्रिया एंड इट इज नॉट वन। That is paraphrased here as अत एव यया यया प्रक्रिया जिज्ञासुर बोधो भवेत् सा सा प्रक्रिया तस्य तस्य समीचीना अभिप्रेता। A prakriya is considered as a good prakriya, samichina, as long as it leads a jijnyasu to bodha. तथापि वाक्यवृत्त्युपदेश सहस्रादौ भाष्यकारैः आभासवाद एव अभ्युपगतः। हाउएवर आभासवाद अमंग दि थ्री प्रतिबिंब आभास एंड अवच्छेदवाद अमंग देम आभासवाद इज क्लियरली एक्सप्लेन और इट सीम्स सो दो देर इज अ सपोर्ट फॉर ऑल वादास इन भाष्य स्टिल भगवान भाष्यकार यूजेस इन वाक्यवृत्ति और इन उपदेश सहस्री इट अपियर्स दैट ही favors avasavada because it uses the benefits of pratibimbavada as well as avachhedavada in a way. So it is easy to understand example and is applicable with the example fits quite closely to how Chaitanya becomes Atma and Ishvara as though. Thereby Abhasavada is accepted. Tasmad Abhasavadayo Mukhya. Among the Vadas, Abhasavada is the primary Vada. Others are focused towards particular kind of adhikaris to bring them to moksha in an easier fashion, in a faster way, based on their own understanding or their own preparation. Sarve api advaita atma avagamartha eva. On that there is a tippana. Sarva shabdena karya karana upadhi vadaha avachinna anavachinna vadaha drishti srishti vadaha ityadaya griyante. You can bring in all types of vadas. We don't know all of them because they are not limited. Some may be having few differences, some may be having a lot of differences, but we may not know these. We need not know all the vadas. Vedantasya aneka pakshanuvadaha api appaya dikshita krita shastra siddhantile shakya grante krita. Wherever there is a contradiction, just like in Puranas, in Shiva Purana, Shiva is praised, therefore Vishnu may be shown as having lesser powers than Shiva. So Shiva will be compared with Vishnu as having superior authority, or Vishnu will be shown as praying to Shiva. And it is the other way around in Vishnu Purana, Bhagavata ityadi. If you, a Padma Purana, etc. So based on the deity, you may have praise of that deity by ninda of the others also. That may be also be possible. Similarly, in these vadas, when the author thinks that this prakriya is more valid, it answers set of questions in a better manner in his perspective, he will show that this vada is superior to others, thereby he may do ninda of the others. Then there is a human tendency, be it however a person is a pandita, there is a human tendency and a tarka also, the methodology in tarka, where you ridicule the other, either through examples or calling out names. This happens in any debate. The debate gets heated up and then there may be name calling also. It is at a very low level, but that does happen even in Shastrartha, because it is human nature. So it is not different from for Tikakaras also. They use it as a trick also in Tarka. So there may be, Vitandavada also. Just because you say it is wrong, so they may go outside the boundary of the debate or the focus area, and then they may go outside and try to ridicule the other person. This happens across Granthas. This name calling is taken as an opportunity to do vada khandana by a third party. There is a debate going on between two and they are calling each other names. They don't care because they know that is not the tatparya. It is a heated argument or it is a trick to fail you, which is okay. You set it aside. Focus on the tattva. This is what we should also do. But there is a third party who may have personal interest, whether they are Dvaitis or so-called Advaitins. They may point out that your tikas, both these tikas are contradictory because they are name calling. That is not the Tatparya Vishaya. But they'll make it a Tatparya Vishaya so that you start hating tikas and come back to their Siddhanta. They may say ours is valid because the other two are invalid. So we should know all this politics we should set aside, and we should see what benefits me in my understanding. Any vada is okay. That is endorsed by even Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya. whatever contradiction has been shown, whether across Puranas or across these Vadas also, or the superiority of one against the other, all these are weighed by Bhagavan Appaya Dikshita in his Shastra Siddhanta Lesha Grantha. So there he analyzes all the things. He says this is not a Tatpari Vishaya. There is no contradiction really. It serves a particular category of seekers. And then he quotes from other sources also as to why Advaita Siddhanta is the Tatpari Vishaya. How one may be superior for that sadhaka. And overall, if you look at it from an adhikari's perspective, which is the best vada as per other quotations also, or which is a shortcut method, which is the real siddhanta as revealed by the Shruti. So which vada is closest to that? Not that others are wrong, which is the closest to the siddhanta? He has weighed out options, and it's kind of a work of samanvaya, so to say. So back to Moola, any prakriya is okay. Then chaturshu mahavakyeshu bhagatyaga lakshana pradarshanam. How does bhagatyaga lakshana apply in mahavakyas? Usually we see the example of tattvamasi. Although there are many mahavakyas, one mahavakya is chosen from each Vedas. Thereby you have four mahavakyas. It is not really limited to four mahavakyas. Any mantra in the Shruti, which is called as a vakya here, any mantra which gives the samanadikaranyam between Ishvara and Jiva, between Brahma and Jiva, is a mahavakya. It may be in various ways across mantras, across Upanishads, but primarily, since there are four Vedas, each of the Vedas has at least a few Mahavakyas in each Upanishad. Each of the Shakhas has an Upanishad, and each Upanishad has at least one, or at least in fact few Mahavakyas. So one Upanishad mantra from each Veda is picked, and these are also the primary mantra for each of the four mathas established by Bhagavan Shankaracharya across India. So we know them as Tattvamasi, the most famous. Then we have Aham Brahmasmi, also famous. We have Prajnanam Brahma and Ayam Atma Brahma. These are the four Mahavakyas. How is Bhagatyaga Lakshana applicable in each of these cases? That is the topic now. Why Lakshana we have seen, why Bhagatyaga Lakshana we have seen. So Shakyartha, Vachyartha does not lead to some meaning which is acceptable, appears contradictory, thereby Lakshana is called for. Among these Lakshanas, only Bhagatyaga Lakshana fits in. So tatra tattvamasiti mahavakye bhagatyaga lakshana yatha maya mayasthavasa maya adhishthana chaitanyam chaiti etatrayam militva sarva shaktitva sarvajyatvadi dharma vishishta ishvara iti kathyate ayam eva tatpada vachyartha. We have seen this. I'll not spend much time on this. So tatpada vachyartha shakyartha, direct meaning is Ishvara, who is sarvajnyatvadi sarva shaktimatvadi dharma vishishta. And the triad of Maya, Abhasa within Maya, and Adhishthana of Maya, Chaitanya, all three put together is called as Ishvara. The triad is Ishvara. Vyashti Avidya, Tatrastha Abhasa, Tad Adhishthana Chaitanyam Chai, Iti Etatrayam Militva Alpa Shaktitva Kinchidnyatvadi Dharma Vishishta Jiva Ityuchyate. Who is Jiva? He is also a triad, avidya, abhasa within avidya, and the adhishthana chaitanya of avidya, all three put together is jiva. Ayam eva tvampada vachyartha. It is also the vachyartha of tvampada. Now tatpada ishvara, tvampada, jiva have been equated. What is contradictory? Alpajnyatva, alpajnyatvadi dharmas in jiva, tvampadavachyartha, and sarvajnyatvadi dharma in tatpadavachyartha. Maya and avidya also have some contradiction. Why? Because of the size that we look at, or sattva guna on one side and malina sattva guna on the other side. So those may also be the contradiction. What is common? Adhisthana chaitanya. There is no contradiction. On either side, there is the same chaitanya. So there is no contradiction there to equate them. In fact, when you solve the equation, what remains is one entity. Even in mathematics, when you solve the left hand side and right hand side, what remains on both sides is the same value. It is not similar, or there is no equation there. Equation is only as long as the formulas are there to be resolved, which appear different but land on the same meaning. So when solved, the left side and right side are the same. They are not similar. There is no equation needed there. That is not an equation. The solved equation is the left hand side is right hand side. I mean, that is what you call as an equation, but then equation in terms of formulas to solve, that is no longer there. You have landed on one single entity. Anayoho ekatvam tattvamasiti vakyam bodhayati. So ekatva is the revelation of the mantra. Etattu na ghatate. Why? Because of contradiction, it doesn't seem valid. Tasmat abhasa sahita mayam. So abhasa sahita mayam vihaya, mayakrita sarvashaktitva sarvajnyatvadi dharmanscha vihaya, tatpada vachyamshan cha vihaya, chaitanya bhagamatra grahane tatpadasya bhagatyagalakshana siddhyati. So when you have a comma after a second case, it's a little tricky to understand. So tasmat abhasa sahita maya, maya kruta sarva shaktitva sarvajnyatvadi dharmanscha tatpada vachyamshan vihaya chaitanya bhagamatra grahane tatpada tatpadasya bhagatyagalakshana siddhyati. So bhagatyagalakshana application here is when you give up the maya on tatpada, maya kruta sarvashaktitva sarvajnyatvadi dharmas also, which is the tatpada vachyartha aunshas. The third aunsha is chaitanya, which is retained, which is aunsha iva aunsha. It is not really an aunsha. It is a whole, purna tattva. So holding on to that, what remains is chaitanya aunsha. Tatpada vachya aunshas are given up. These are the vachya aunsha, maya and maya kruta sarvashaktitvadi dharma. So you have bhagatyaga lakshana on the tatpada. Tatha abhasa sahita avidya aunsham avidya kruta alpashaktitva kinchijnyatvadi dharmanscha tvampada vachya aunshan vihaya chaitanya bhagamatra grahane tvampadasya bhagatyaga lakshana siddhyati. Then on the tvampada you have bhagatyaga lakshana by giving up abhasa sahita avidya aunsha along with avidya kruta alpashaktitva kinchijnyatvadi dharmas, which is the tvampada vachyartha. Vachyartha aunshas again, not vachyartha complete, vachyartha aunshas. But you are really giving the vachyartha. What leads to it is the artha is dropped, part of it. So if you take vachyartha, it has three aunshas. The two are given up and then the third is held on to, which is what? Chaitanya bhagamatra. Thereby, bhagatyaga lakshana is applied on both padas. Ittham bhagatyaga lakshanaya jiveshwara rupastha lakshyarthabhuta chaitanya aunsha shakyam tattvamasi iti mahavakyam bodhayati. Ittham bhagatyaga lakshanaya, through bhagatyaga lakshana on both padas, jiveshwara swarupastha lakshyarthabhuta chaitanya aunsha ikyam tattvamasi iti mahavakyam bodhayati. So aunsha ikyam, there is aikya between aunshas of tat and tvam. Which aunsha? Chaitanya aunsha. Thereby that chaitanya aunsha is the lakshyartha, whereas the other two are dropped in the vachyartha. Other two aunshas are dropped in jiva as well as ishvara. So jiveshvara swarupa is the lakshyartha, vachyartha is not the swarupa, it is incidental. So you have a tippana. Idancha tattvamasiti vakyam padayo samanadikaranam padarthayor visheshana vishesha bhavah pratyagatma paramatmanor lakshana lakshya bhavascha iti sambandhatrayena akhandartham bodhayati. I want to see what is there in the moola before. So there is not much moola here. Most of it is covered in. So in Tattvamasi itself, before dealing with the other Mahavakyas, we'll go through the Tippana. So Tippanakara analyzes these and he goes further. So in fact, what we can do is, since he goes further, we'll come back to the Tippana. We'll finish the moola, because the Tippana is long again. So in Tattvamasi analysis, he has used this, but he extends this to the others as well. Others are covered in the moola a little later. So we saw in Tattvamasi what is the Bhagatyaga Lakshana. In Tatpada as well as Tvampada, the Chaitanya Amsha is retained, whereas the others are dropped. So here Aikyam and Tattvamasi, on that there is a Tippana. We'll come back to that. So the second Mahavakya, Evam Eva Ayam Atma Brahma Iti Mahavakya Pi Bhagatyaga Lakshana Bodhya. In the case of Ayam Atma Brahma, now these are also covered in Tippana. We'll look at all those together. So Ayam Atma Brahma, this Atma is Brahma. Ayam is a Prathama Ekvachana in Pullinga of Idam Shabda. Idam is used for something which is proximal. So in Tat Tvam, when Tvam is said, the listener hears it as Aham. He interprets as Aham. He hears it as Tvam but interprets it as Aham. So here his understanding is Tat Aham Asmi, which lands to Aham Brahmasmi later. Aham Brahmasmi is a Vakya that he understands through Tattvamasi. Aham Brahmasmi independently is also mantra. Whether it is Tattvamasi, where he understands that Tat Aham Asmi, or Aham Brahmasmi, they have very similar shades. They have a different, they have differences also, but still it can also be seen as a same statement from the perspective of the listener. However, Tattvamasi mantra as it is in the Shruti is taught to Shvetaketu. Then it is explained as whoever is Shvetaketu Staniya, to that Jiva also it is applicable. Thereby there is a difference as well. Tattvamasi, when Aham Brahmasmi is heard, then if the Shishya is also chanting along Aham Brahmasmi, then he is able to think in the first person for Pratyagatma. So we'll see what is the progression across the four Mahavakyas. They have specific meaning, or they have specific differences. However, you land on the same meaning through Lakshyartha. Evam eva ayam atma brahma iti mahavakya api bhagatyaga lakshana bodhya. You have to understand bhagatyaga lakshana or apply that and land on the meaning in the case of ayam atma brahma also. Tathahi atra atma iti padase jivaha vachyartha. Vachyartha is jiva, just like tvampada vachyartha.
ब्रह्म इति पद से ईश्वर वाच्य, वाच्यार्थ शक्यार्थ और ब्रह्म शब्द इज ईश्वर नॉट निर्गुण ब्रह्म। अत्र ब्रह्म पद से शुद्धम चैतन्यम न वाच्यम, वाच्यार्थ इज नॉट शुद्ध चैतन्य निर्गुण ब्रह्म। देयरफॉर ईश्वर सगुण ब्रह्म इज द वाच्यार्थ, किंतु ईश्वर एव इति एतत् चतुर्थे तरंगे प्रतिपादितम्। दिस हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द फोर्थ चैप्टर इन दिस वर्क। पूर्ववदत्रापि पदद्वयस्य लक्षणं ग्राह्या। सो ईच पद वाच्यार्थ हैज टू बी टेकन लाइक इन द केस ऑफ तत्त्वमसि। हियर यू हैव अयम एंड ब्रह्म, अयम आत्मा ब्रह्म। सो अयम, अयम इज इन सामान्यीकरण विद आत्मा, एंड आत्मा मीन्स प्रत्येगात्मा, बट प्रत्येगात्मा इज द लक्ष्यार्थ, इज शुद्ध चैतन्य। व्हेन यू से प्रत्येगात्मा एज अ रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन, आत्मा एज अ रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन, देन आत्मा इज अ नाउन, बट व्हेन यू सी इट एज अ रिफ्लेक्सिव यूजेज विद अयम, अयम इज दिस एंड दैट इज रिफ्लेक्सिव टू मी बिकॉज इट इज इन सामान्यीकरण विद आत्मा, एंड आत्मा मीन्स वन सेल्फ, दैट इज द रिफ्लेक्सिव सेंस देयर। बट वॉट काइंड ऑफ मी, द जीवा इज वाच्यार्थ, देयर बाय जस्ट लाइक अर्लियर यू हैव टू डू भागत्याग लक्षण ईच पदान। सो आत्मा इति पदस्य जीव वाच्यार्थ, कासा आत्मा इत्युक्ते अयम, देन अयम आल्सो दिस बीइंग द प्रोनाउन इदम मैस्कुलिन फॉर्म, विदाउट नोइंग द डिफरेंसेस इन लिंगा वन मे कंसीडर एनीथिंग दैट इज क्लोज एज दिस। हाउएवर व्हेन आत्मा इज सेड इट हैज टू अप्लाई टू whom now, my atma or somebody else's atma, that may also be a question, because in the context it has been said I am atma brahma, atma has been taught and said to be brahma, so one may not directly understand it as talking about me, unlike in tattvamasi or aham, in aham brahma asmi. So atra brahma padasya shuddham chaitanyam navacham, किंतु ईश्वर एव इति एतत् चतुर्थ तरंगे प्रतिपादन पूर्ववदत्रापि पदद्वयस्य लक्षणा ग्राह्य। लक्ष्यार्थभूत चैतन्यं नैव परोक्षं किंतु नित्य अपरोक्षं एव इति इमं अर्थं बोधयितुं एव अयम् इति पदं प्रयुक्तम्। हाउएवर व्हेन यू से अयम, दैट बीइंग प्रॉक्सिमल, one has to understand what is that I am, what is that proximity of this versus that, idam versus tat or adash shabda. So idam is closer, idam etat, these are proximal. In fact idam is even more proximal than etat. So when you say eshaha, it is used better in the case of another. Ayam is something which is very proximal and that happens to be you, so proximal that there is no difference at all. However, ayam has to be understood in the context of the mantra there. So ayam brahmadi stambha अंत, सो ब्रह्म आदि स्तंभ अंत, स्टार्टिंग विद ब्रह्म चतुर्मुख ब्रह्म एंड एंडिंग विद अ ब्लेड ऑफ ग्रास और अ स्मॉल इंसेक्ट आल्सो। सर्व प्राणिनाम अहम अहम इति नित्य अपरोक्षतया भासमान आत्मा एव ब्रह्म इति वाक्यार्थ। सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अयम आत्मा ब्रह्म, अयम इज दैट, so not that, because that is the meaning of tatpada. So generally we, in explanation of vigraha in English you land on that, but here it is ayam means this brahma or this Brahma is Chaturmukha, so you cannot really say this. However, the meaning of this is this entity who can be having the Sharira of Chaturmukha Brahma down to any small prani also, including every being in the process. So the entire set, that is the meaning of I am. So I am Brahmadi Stambhanta Sarva Praninam Aham Aham Iti Nitya Aparokshayatraya Bhasamana Atma Eva. But it is not the Sharira. In that Sharira, in the Brahma Sharira, in Chaturmukha Brahma Sharira, there is Pratiti of Aham. I am. Aham Asmi, Aham Bhami. I am there. I shine forth as myself, I am conscious being, I am an existent conscious being. This is there not only for us, it is there for each and every being, whether it is Chaturmukha Brahma, another Devata, a Rakshasa, a bird, a plant, an insect, an animal, a human being, man or a woman. So for everyone there is Aham Aham Pratiti, which appears as reflexive eye. That is the meaning of Ayam Shabda. Then Ayam, that Ayam which has Purana of Aham, Aham Aham's Purana, iti Nitya Parokshataya, and that Aham is never Prathama Purusha or Madhyama Purusha. Aham Aham is always Uttama Purusha. In Gita, you swap the words, you will get Purushottama Yoga, 15th chapter, which is about Uttama Purusha. Purusha Uttama is Uttama Purusha, Aham. So that Narayana, who is Purushottama, is really Uttama Purusha in each and every being. Brahmadi Stambha Paryantam. Therefore, it is Nitya Paroksha, Aham. Nobody needs to tell you about that I, you know that I without any help from anyone else or from any other instrument. No Karana is needed. You wake up to the Karana, but no Karana is needed to wake you up. You are always there. Thereby, Aham Asmi Aham Bhami, that is I am. In Samanadikarana with Atma. So that Atma, which is seen in each and every being, is Anubhuta in each and every being, Spurita in each and every being as Aham Aham. That is Aparoksha. And that is Brahma, equated to Brahma. Meaning I am equated, the I in each and every being is equated to Brahma. Iti Vakyartha. That is the meaning of the sentence. You have to land on the Laksharta I. Appears to be with the body-mind-sense complex, but that I is not different from Chaturmukha Brahma's I, the Kita's I, the Vriksha's I, the I for anyone. Wherever there is Aham, that is I. I as in Uttama Purusha. I alone am there in each and every being, shining forth as Aham Aham. Thereby, I am that Brahma who is all pervasive across all Shariras, in all sentient beings, shining forth as Uttama Purusha. That is the meaning. Then Aham Brahma Asmi is also well known mantra. Iti mahavakya api aham padasya jivaha vachya brahma padasya ishvara vachya anayoho padayo shuddha chaitanya amshe lakshana aham eva param brahma iti vakyartha. Very clear, nothing to see there. We have seen it in Tattvamasi also. So jiva is the meaning of aham shabda, brahma is the ishvara is the meaning of brahma shabda. You apply bhagatya lakshana on both places, you land on शुद्ध चैतन्य विच इज दी भागत्याग लक्षण रिजल्ट ऑन बोथ पदार्स सॉरी प्रज्ञानम आनंदम ब्रह्म इति महावाक्ये प्रज्ञान पदस्य जीवः वाच्य प्रज्ञान दैट कॉन्शियसनेस व्हाट इज दैट रियली द कॉन्शियस एंटिटी इज जीव दिस एंशिएंट बीइंग सो यू से यू नो यू टॉक अबाउट समथिंग व्हिच कैन नॉट स्पीक यू से मूक प्राणी इन साउथ इंडियन लैंग्वेज यू विल से यू नो पापा जीव सो दैट जीव जीव इज द वाच्यार्थ देयर व्हेन यू से You look at some spurana somewhere, you know it is alive. Even if it is hurt, you want to help it out because you see life there. So you see it is a conscious entity. So that prajnana is the meaning it is, or the word standing for jiva. It is the vachaka of jiva. Then Brahma is Ishvara. Thereby, Brahma padasya Ishvara vachya, Prajnana padasya Jivaha vachya, and then there is an equation. Purvavad ubhayoho shuddha chaitanya aushe lakshana. Again, you have to land on, through lakshana, you have to land on lakshyartha, which is the shuddha chaitanya aushe in both padas through bhagatyaga lakshana. Lakshyartha bhuta pratyagabhinna brahmatma न आनंद गुण युक्त आनंद इज नॉट अ गुण इट इज सेड प्रज्ञानम आनंदम ब्रह्म सेड आनंद इज नॉट द गुण ऑफ शुद्ध चैतन्य ब्रह्म निर्गुण ब्रह्म आत्मा प्रत्यग अभिन्न ब्रह्मात्मा इज नॉट endowed with ananda as a guna that guna which has gradations ananda has gradations priya moda pramoda kind of gradations however such ananda is not guna of brahmatma kintu ananda swarupa eva iti artha avagamaya ananda pada adhyara krutah Ananda has been added there in the mantra. Why? To bring out this idea that Ananda is the swarupa of what? Of that Brahma which is the Lakshyartha, of that Atma which is the Lakshyartha, of respective padas. So Prajnana Jiva Pada Vachyartha has Chetana Ansha. Which is Ananda, which is not different from Nirguna Brahma Chetana Ansha in Ishvara, which is Ananda Swarupa. So, Pratyagabhinnam Brahma Ananda Swarupam iti Vakyarthaha. What is the meaning? Meaning is that Pratyag Atma, who is Brahma, Shuddha Chaitanya, is Ananda Swarupa. यथा महावाक्यस्थ पदानां भागत्याग लक्षण तथा वाक्यांतरेषु भी सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम इत्यादि पदानि भागत्याग लक्षणया एव शुद्धं ब्रह्म बोधयन्ति वी विल कम बैक टू दिस इट इज मूव्ड ऑन टू एप्लीकेशन इन अवांतर वाक्यस आल्सो हाउ भागत्याग लक्षण यूजेस इन अवांतर वाक्य वी विल कम बैक टू दिस वी विल गो टू टिप्पणा सो टिप्पणा एक्सप्लेन्स हाउ दिस भागत्याग लक्षण इज एप्लीकेबल इदं च तत्त्वमसीति महावाक्यं पदयोः सामानादिकरण्यं पदार्थयोर् विशेषण विशेष्य भावः प्रत्यगात्म परमात्मनोर् लक्षण लक्ष्य भावश्च इति सम्बन्धत्रेण अखण्डार्थं बोधयति व्हाट इज द अखण्डार्थ व्हाट इज द कंप्लीट मीनिंग देयर वेयर देयर आर नो विशेषणास् अखण्डार्थ इज देयर वेयर देयर इज नो खंडा पॉसिबल खंडन्न विद्यते यस्मिन् तत् अखण्डम् In this case, akhandaha, arthaha, because artha is pullinga, gahi pratyayanta perhaps. So, akhanda artha is revealed by or the mahavakya interpretation leads to what understanding? there are three separate units of understanding. In the Tattvamasi Mahavakya, as an example, Idancha Tattvamasi iti Vakyam. That Vakya Bodhayati reveals what? Akhandartha. How? Through three Sambandhas, Sambandha Trayena. So Tat and Tvam, Asi, these are the three Padas there. There is Samanadikaranyam of Tat with Tam, Tvam. So that is the first Sambandha. Pada, between the two Padas, Tat Pada and Tvam Pada, there is Samanadikaranyam. Then Padarthayoho Visheshana Vishesha Bhavaha. Between Tat and Tvam, there is Visheshana Vishesha Bhava. Between Padartha Tat and Padartha of Tvam. Between the Padas, there is Samanadikarana. Between the Padarthas, there is Visheshana Vishesha Bhava. That is one Sambandha. Another Sambandha, second one. Pratyagatma Paramatma. Between Pratyagatma and Paramatma, there is Lakshana Laksha Bhavaha. That is the Sambandha. So first Sambandha is between Tatpada and Tvampada. That is Samanadikarana Sambandha. Between the Tatpadartha Ishvara and Tvampadartha Jiva, there is a Visheshana Vishesha Bhava. Between Pratyagatma and Paramatma, meaning Shakshi Chaitanya and the Brahma Chaitanya, there is Lakshana Laksha Bhava. We'll see what exactly this is. This is a broad overview, not completely accurate. We have to see, analyze this further in the Tika, or the Tika Kara analyzes this further and says, Tatra Padayoho Samanadikaranya Sambandho Yatha. How can there be Samanadikaranya Sambandha between these? What is the real Visheshana Vishesha Bhava between these Padarthas? What is the Lakshana Laksha Bhava between Pratyagatma and Paramatma? So that is explained, between what and what exactly. So here it is not really between. It can also mean Shashti in the sense of for these words. What kind of Sambandha is there? Between what, we'll see further. Because it is not clear in this statement. It can be more confusing. So don't let your mind run havoc. It is going to be explained further. So first Sambandha is Samanadikarana between the two Padas. Tatra Padayoho Samanadikaranya Sambandha Yatha. Soyam Devadatta iti Vakye, Tatkaladi Vishishta Devadatta Vachakasya Saha iti Padasya, Etatkaladi Vishishta Devadatta Vachakasya Ayam iti Padasya cha, Eka Devadatta Sharire Tatpariyat. Ubhayoho Padayo Samanadikaranya Sambandha. What is Samanadikaranya? Bhinnartayoho Padayoho Ekartha Bodhakatva Rupaha. That kind of Sambandha. Siddhyati. So there are bhinna arthayoho padayoho ekartha bodhakatva rupa sambandha. Both reveal the same meaning. Which are those two padarthas? The two padas have commitment to reveal the same entity. Or they have the padas, tat and tvam, just like saha ayam. Saha ayam devadattaha. Saha and ayam are two different padas which have bhinna artha. What is the meaning of saha? Saha is prathama ekvachana of tat in pullinga. Ayam is prathama ekvachana of idam shabda in pullinga. So Tatpada and Idampada have different meanings, Bhinnartha. Tat means that, Ayam means this. That and this have different meanings. But when you say that is this Devadatta, thereby Samanadikaranyam is there between Tatpada and Idampada. Saha and Ayam. Tat as Pratipadika, Idam as Pratipadika on the other side. So Saha Ayam are in Samanadikaranyam. And they have commitment to reveal what? एकार्थ, अ सिंगल अर्थ, सह हैज द सेम अर्थ एज अयम, ऑल्दो दे हैव भिन्न अर्थज ऑल्सो, दे रिवील, ऑल्दो हैविंग भिन्न अर्थज, दे रिवील एकार्थ, देर बाय पदयोर एकार्थ बोधकत्व रूप संबंध सिद्ध्यति. सो इन दी स्टेटमेंट सह अयम, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सह, भिन्न अर्थ फ्रॉम अयम, सह मीन्स तत्कालादि विशिष्ट देवदत्त. सो देवदत्त हू वाज सीन इन अ डिफरेंट प्लेस एंड टाइम, अयम हैज अ भिन्न अर्थ टू सह बाय हैविंग द मीनिंग एज व्हाट, एतत् काल आदि विशिष्ट. सो देर इज एतत् देश एंड एतत् काल विशिष्ट देवदत्त. सो बोथ आर वाचकस ऑफ अ डिफरेंट प्लेस एंड टाइम, बट तात्पर्य इज इन वन देवदत्त शरीर. यू लुक एट दिस देवदत्त एंड से दिस इज दैट देवदत्त. रियली द तात्पर्य इज नॉट इन द शरीर, बट यू सी द पर्सन एज अ शरीर, देयर फोर शरीर इज बीन मेंशनड हियर. तथा तत्त्वमसि इति वाक्ये परोक्षत्वादि धर्म विशिष्ट चैतन्य वाचकस्य तत्पदस्य अपरोक्षत्वादि धर्म विशिष्ट चैतन्य वाचकस्य त्वं पदस्य च एकस्मिन्नेव चैतन्ये तात्पर्यात् उभयोः पदयोः तत्त्वं पदयोः समानादिकरणं सिद्ध्यति. सिमिलरली इन द एग्जांपलिफाइड तत्त्वमसि महावाक्य, तत् मीन्स ईश्वर हु इज नॉट अपरोक्ष, इज परोक्ष. शास्त्र टॉक्स अबाउट ईश्वर, ध्यान on a particular Ishwara with particular characteristics, with particular look, a form revealed in a particular sound and so on. There are various ways in which Ishwara is revealed. Jagat Karta, Sarvajnyatva, all these are gunas also. So in various ways Shastra talks about Ishwara who is Paroksha to Jiva. So he is endowed with paroksha dharmas or dharmas which are paroksha, not paroksha dharmas, same meaning, but sarvajnyatvadi, all these dharmas, the rupa, all of these are paroksha to the jiva. However, parokshatvadi dharma visheshta chaitanya, finally these are visheshanas, dharmas are visheshanas to chaitanya. So it's a conglomerate where the vachaka is tatpada. Now aparokshadvadi dharma vishishta chaitanya, which is the tvampada vachyartha jiva, who is aparoksha to oneself, jiva is aparoksha to himself, therefore aparokshatva is on one side, parokshatva on the other side, and we have seen other contradictory attributes, sarvajnyatva, alpajnyatva, ityadi. What is the tatparya? Ekasmin eva chaitanye tatparya. Since there is tatparya in one chaitanya, the ubhayo padayoho samanadikaranam siddhyati. This is the samanadikaranam, which is the samanadikaranam sambandha between, so out among these sambandha traya, first is samanadikaranyam. Therefore tattvamasi, in tat and tvam there is samanadikaranyam, samanadikaran sambandha. Visheshana vishesha bhava is the next sambandha. What is that? Visheshana vishesha bhava sambandho yatha itarebhyo vyavartakam visheshanam. So that, what is a visheshana? Visheshana is vyavartaka, that which differentiates one from others. Itarebhyo vyavartakam visheshanam. So when you say something has to be seen among many, you add a visheshana. So there are, you know, two, three people in the kitchen. You don't know their names. And you want to point out someone to the other. So one, you'll add a visheshana. Look at this person, tall. The person who is singing or one who is cooking, whatever it is. So this is how you will add a visheshana to differentiate from the others. Thereby, what is a visheshana? It is that which is used to differentiate one from the others. So itarebhyo vyavartakam, differentiator, is a visheshana. Vyavartyam visheshyam. And what is visheshya? That which is differentiated. This is the visheshana vishesha bhava. Soyam devadatta iti vakye ayam iti shabda bodhya etaddesha kaladi visishta devadatta sa iti shabda bodhya taddesha kaladi visishta devadatta na bhidyate iti yada avedha pratiyate tada ayam iti shabda vachyartha nishta bhedam sa iti shabdartho vyavartayati. So in the vakya saha ayam devadatta, there what is the visheshana vishesha bhava there? Ayam iti saha ayam. In that statement, ayam iti shabda bodhya. Who is that ayam? Ayam is etad desha kaladi visheshta devadatta. Who is there here and now? In this place and at this time, there is one devadatta. Who is this devadatta? Ayam. Saha iti shabda bodhyat vyavartayati. Ayam differentiates this devadatta from that devadatta. How so? Equation is there, but then there is a difference also. That's why you use bhagatyag lakshana. Why do you say ayam? He has this place and time. He is available in this place and time. Who is saha? Saha was available in a different place and time. Therefore, ayam is differentiating this devadatta of this place and time from that devadatta who is not here and now. Thereby, ayam is differentiating from saha. So what is said here is etad desha kaladi visishta devadatta is ayam iti shabda bodhyaha. Saha iti shabda bodhya tad desha kaladi visishta devadattat na bhidyate. However, what is being said? Na bhidyate. Yada iti yada abheda pratiyate. Tada ayam iti shabda vachyartha nishta bhedam. Saha iti shabdhartha vyavartayati. What is the real difference there? Since saha and ayam are different, but when you said saha ayam devadatta in samanadikaranyam, that is the entire sentence. See, in anvaya, you can reorder to make more sense of the words. So if it is a long sentence, then you can say saha ramaha ayam lakshmanaha cha somewhere and say vanam gachataha. It's a simpler sentence but has more words than soyam devadatta. There when you say soyam, soyam ramaha lakshmanascha vanam gachataha, or gachati also is fine. Gachati, let's just say gachati. You can, you know, expand the sentence and as saha ramaha vanam gachati, ayam lakshmanascha vanam gachati. There soyam are not in samanadikaranyam. The definition of samanadikaranyam is what? Not definition per se, but they should have bhinnartha. So saha ayam have bhinnartha in the case of soyam ramaha lakshmanascha vanam gachati. But there is no ekartha bodhakatva rupa sambandha. There are many teachers who give the definition and definition is held on to literally. So people who are studying Sanskrit are unable to really understand the meaning of samanadikaranyam. Samanadikaranyam is not having the same case and number. Although that is the definition, you can also have different case and number but still have samanadikaranyam. So vibhaktis need not be same. Although in the definition it is said that vibhaktis have to be same, you have to understand the meaning of samanadhikaranam as a samasa. Samanam adhikaranam yayoho. So that is the meaning of samanadhikaranam. Those and tasya bhava samanadhikaranyam. Or tayoho bhavaha samanadhikaranyam. Samanadhikaranam is only when two words have a samana adhikarana. That adhikarana can be expressed with different words also. So if I, there is a statement saying that let's say Ayodhya Patihi Ramaha or Sita Patihi Ramaha. Let's say Ayodhya Patihi Ramaha. Tasya Patni Sita. Tasya Bharya Sita. Now, Ayodhya Patihi Ramaha are in Samanadhikaranam. Prathama Ekvachana. Have Ekartha Bodhakatvam. What about Tasya? Tasya Patni Sita. There Tasya and Tasya is in Shashti Ekvachana. Ayodhya Pati and Rama are in Prathama Ekvachana. They also are in Samanadhikaranam. So, there is no Eka Vivaktikatvam. So, this is an aside to tell you how Mimamsa works. We have to understand the Adhikarana when you understand, analyze Samanadhikaranam. Thereby, Visheshana Vishesha Bhava, when you are analyzing, Visheshana Vishesha Bhava Sambandha here, Soyam Devadatta, unlike in Soyam Ramaha Lakshmanascha. Saha Ramaha Ayam Lakshmana, or it can be Saha Lakshmana Ayam Ramaha. There is no Samanadhikaran between Saha and Ayam. However, in the case of Soyam Devadatta, Ekating Vakyam, thereby Soyam Devadatta Asti Bhavati. Thereby Saha and Ayam. Saha has Ting Samanadhikaran with Asti. Ayam has Ting Samanadhikaran with Asti. And Saha and Ayam have Tatparya in revealing the same entity. Adhikarana is same. Thereby Samanadhikaranam is there. It is not only because of Vibhakti. So here the sentence is very easy to see. Saha Ayam Devadatta. In Saha and Ayam there is Samanadhikaranam. Now this Saha in another Desha and Kala and Ayam in this Desha and Kala are one and the same. That is the Tatparya. So there is no differentiation between them. What is seen as different is said to be one, predicated as one Devadatta. Thereby, what is the Visheshana Visheshya Bhava? Visheshana is Vyavartaka. So who is differentiated from whom? Here it is oneness. In oneness there is no differentiation. In fact, differentiation is taken away. So what is said is, Saha iti shabda bodhyat ayam iti shabdaha na bhidyate iti yada abheda pratiyate. When there is an abheda pratiti between Saha and Ayam, then the Visheshana or Vyavartakattvam is what? Tada Ayam iti Shabda Vachyartha Nishta Bhedam. For this you have to know some tarka. There is Bheda in Ayam from Saha. Saha and Ayam are different words. That and this are not same words. So there is a Bhinnartha. There is Bheda in Ayam. What is that Bheda? Bheda from Saha. So the Bheda from Saha is sitting in Ayam. It is Nishtha in Ayam. Has Nishtha in Ayam. So Ayam iti Shabda Vachyartha Nishtha Bhedam. There is difference from Saha sitting in Ayam. Really. So Shabda Vachya Artha Nishtha Bhedam. Saha iti shabdartha vyavartayati. It takes away the saha. by oneness. If you know one, then what is it differentiating? It is not differentiating the bheda which is there in ayam iti shabda, shabda vachyartha, that differentiates the shabdhartha from saha. If you understand the meaning of saha as that, then ayam differentiates that or separates that meaning from saha. It is not that elsewhere, it is here and now. Therefore, there is a vyavartaka, and that vyavartakattvam is visheshanattvam. So, visheshana is there, ataha saha iti visheshanam, ayam iti shabdarthasya vyavartyatvat, ayam iti visheshyam. So, ayam is visheshya to saha as visheshana, इत्थं सह एव अयम् अयम् एव सह इति वाक्यद्वयनिष्ठयोः सह अयम् इति पदयोः अन्योन्यं विशेषण विशेष्य भावेन अस्ति तत्त्वात् विशेषण विशेष्य भावः सिद्ध्यति. नाउ इट इज अप्लाइड इन द केस ऑफ वेदर यू से अयम् एव सह सह एव अयम् द विशेषण विशेष्य भाव विल स्वैप अक्रॉस. वन विल बिकम द विशेषण, द अदर विल बिकम विशेष्य बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट इज द प्रेडिकेटेड. What differentiates the bheda from the other? So, based on the perspective, both have visheshana visheshya bhava. Etad drishtantena tattvamasiti vakyapi tvampada vachyartha bhuta aparokshatva kinchidnyatvadi dharma visishta chaitanyam tattpada vachyartha bhuta parokshatvadi dharma visishta chaitanyat abhinnam iti yada pratitir jayate. Just like in saha अयम देवदत्ता सोयम देवदत्ता, when the abheda is revealed, then how one word takes away the meaning of the other, which is the vachyartha, and thereby becomes a vyavartaka, visheshana to the other. Similarly in tattvam asi mahavakya also, when the aikya is known, तदा त्वं पदार्थनिष्ठ भेदम्, देयर इज भेद इन त्वं पद, तत्पदार्थ व्यावर्तयति. सो आई सेड इट द अदर वे अराउंड, देयर इट इज देयर आल्सो व्हाट इज सेड देयर, या अयम इति शब्द वाच्यार्थनिष्ठ भेदम् सह इति शब्दार्थो व्यावर्तयति. आई सेड दैट अयम इज अ विशेषण, हियर इन दिस सेंटेंस दिस इज भेदम् व्यावर्तयति. कः व्यावर्तयति? स इति शब्दः. स इज दि व्यावर्तक, सः इज विशेषण, एंड अतः स इति विशेषणम्, एंड अयम इति व्यावर्त्यत्वात् विशेष्यम्. एंड इफ यू यू नो स्वैप दीज वर्ड्स आल्सो, व्हेन यू से सोयम देवदत्ता, सः हैज व्हाट, सः हैज सः अयम, जस्ट लाइक अयम, सः इति शब्द शब्दार्थस्य अयम इज सीन. सो फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ सह, सह इज विशेषण टू अयम. व्हाई? बिकॉज सह टेक्स अवे भेद विच इज निष्ठ इन वाच्यार्थ ऑफ द अयम शब्द. नाउ इफ यू टेक सह शब्द, सह शब्द हैज भेद फ्रॉम अयम, दैट इज निष्ठ इन सह शब्द मीनिंग तत् शब्द. सो तत् शब्द सह इज पद विच इज द प्रथमा एक वचन इन पुल्लिंग ऑफ तत्शब्द. सो तत्शब्द वाच्यार्थनिष्ठ भेदम अयम इति शब्दार्थो व्यावर्तयति. देयरफॉर अयम विल बिकम विशेषण एंड सह विल बिकम विशेष्य बेस्ड ऑन द पर्सपेक्टिव. सो आई होप यू गेट द आइडिया. बोथ वेज देयर कैन बी विशेषण विशेष संबंध, बिकॉज यू हैव टू एनालाइज इन ऑल वेज फ्रॉम बोथ पर्सपेक्टिव. It is samanadikaran in the true sense, where saha ayam, ayam saha. Tattvamasi, tvam tatasi. So, tattvamasi, tvam tatasi, both ways it works. Thereby, visheshana vishesha sambandha is there both ways. Vyavartakattvam is seen differently. Visheshana vishesha bhava may be there, but does not mean that visheshana differentiates from something else or only a particular set of things. Vyavartakattvam can be work in any which way. So it's a very interesting way it is explained. इन तत्वमसी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग त्वंपद वाच्यार्थ भूत अपरोक्षत्व किंचिज्ञत्वाति धर्म विशिष्ट चैतन्य वंस चैतन्य इज सीन एज अभिन्न इन तत् एंड त्वम देन व्हाटएवर डिफरेंसेस आर देयर इन त्वंपद दैट इज टेकन अवे बाय द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ चैतन्य ऑन द तत्पद देयरफॉर तत् विल बिकम अ विशेषण टू त्वम देन त्वम चैतन्य विल टेक अवे द सर्वज्ञत्वादि विशेषणाज विच आर कॉजिंग भेद सिटिंग इन व्हाट सिटिंग इन द तत्पद वाच्यार्थ देयर बाय त्वम विल बिकम विशेषण एंड तत् विल बिकम विशेष्य सो विशेषण विशेष्य भाव इज देयर त्वम पदार्थस्य व्यावर्त्यत्वात् त्वम पदम विशेष्यम् इत्थम् तत्त्वमसि त्वम तदसि इति वाक्ययोः त्वम पद पदयोः अन्योन्यम् विशेषण विशेष्य भाव संबंध सिद्ध्यति There is visheshana vishesha bhava between tvam and tat because from both perspectives each can become visheshana, the other can become visheshya by taking away the bheda nishta in the other. Through the understanding of chaitanya which is eka in both, therefore bheda is taken away and due to that differentiator or due to taking away that bheda It is visheshana and the other is visheshya. There is a visheshana visheshya sambandha. We'll look at the lakshana laksha sambandha in the next part. Sukhan nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namarupe adhishthanam buddhye bodhyam buddher drakyatva nirmala param sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak paramah tadeva annamatto nirithime nishchitamatihi. Namaste.